Merci, Monsieur le Président. Ma question est pour le ministre du Travail, the Honourable Kevin Flynn. Speaker, the Standing Committee on General Government met earlier this week for clause-by-clause consideration of an important piece of legislation, Bill 18, the Stronger Workplaces for a Stronger Economy Act. Speaker, with your permission, I'd like to commend the third party, as I often do, for joining with the government in putting forward important, enhancing and substantive amendments, which ultimately strive to capture the many lessons learned during our consultations with the public and stakeholders. But regrettably, Speaker, the official opposition resorted to procedural games, filibusters and delaying tactics in an obvious attempt to derail the proceedings. They introduced hundreds, Speaker, hundreds of repetitive, meaningless amendments in order to tie up the proceedings. These disruptive efforts, I'm pleased to say, were met with sheer determination on our government side. Speaker, the committee has completed its work. Third reading debate has been completed. So can we get on with this bill?
Thank you. Minister of Labour.
Thank you, Speaker. I want to thank the member for his important and very timely question on this bill. I want to begin by thanking the majority of the General Committee for the hard work, for the contributions and the advocacy they've had for workers in the development of this bill, and especially the chair, the member from Glencairn, Prescott and Russell, for the excellent work he did the other night. Passing this bill is about protecting workers in this province. We can't afford to delay it any further than these tactics already have. One of the main features of the bill is changes to the minimum wage that are based on the Consumer Price Index. It's going to provide certainty to workers, certainty to business, and they're able to plan for any changes in the future to the minimum wage. Speaker, in order for this bill to come into effect in time for next year for workers in the province of Ontario, this bill needs to pass through the legislature in a very short period of time. I'm hoping all members will support it today.
Supplementary.
Thank you, Speaker. As my colleague from Trinity Spadina reminds me, he's actually endured 400 filibuster-type amendments. So we have to commend, I think, the government side for that. Speaker, the workers of Ontario, I think, appreciate our overall efforts. On their collective behalf, I think it's clear that we can, should, and must vote in favour of Bill 18 today, particularly if our intention is to tie the minimum wage to inflation. And of course, Speaker, organizationally, this has to be implemented soon in time for next year. Minister, Bill 18 will be brought back to the House, I think momentarily, for a third and final reading before it's voted upon. If passed, promises to make stronger protections for thousands of workers across the province will, of course, emanate this new law. Speaker, I'd like to know,
question?
What can I report back to the people of the great riding of Etobicoke North with regard to Bill 18?
Thank you. Minister of Labour.
Thank you, Speaker. Thank you for the excellent supplementary. Speaker, the member is absolutely correct. It's been nearly a year and many, many hours of debate since we first proposed the Stronger Workplaces for a Stronger Economy Act, which will, if passed, it takes very important steps to ensure that every Ontarian in this province gets the paycheck they've earned at the end of the day. It protects vulnerable workers from dangerous working situations, and it makes our businesses more competitive, Speaker, and it ensures they treat their workers fairly. It ties annual changes in the minimum wage to inflation. We need to pass it now in order for this to take effect in 2015, Speaker. Speaker, this morning members will have a chance to vote on this important piece of legislation in third reading. I would urge all members of the House to continue their support of this bill at third reading, just as we did unanimously as a group at second reading, Speaker. I urge that support.